Known as the place where news happens, the National Press Club has been a Washington institution for more than a century. Located just blocks from the White House, it's where political power players make news and discuss the contentious issues of the day. Allegheny College, 330 miles northwest of Washington in Meadville, Pennsylvania, selected the National Press Club as home of the Allegheny College Prize for Civility in Public Life.
There they are.
The prize was created to annually recognize two political figures, one liberal and one conservative, who argue passionately but with civility for their beliefs. The inaugural award went to political journalists David Brooks and Mark Shields in recognition of their long-standing record of civil commentary. In the second year of the prize, as the nation is deeply embroiled in hotly contested, polarizing debates, the college judged it important to highlight civility at the epicenter of contention in U.S. politics. So a small group of advisors to the college, trustees, and those in the political arena set out to identify two worthy recipients who currently hold elected office. The standard wasn't civil perfection, but rather a body of work that underscores what civility looks like where it is needed most, in our nation's capital.
Allegheny College is honored to award its 2013 Prize for Civility in Public Life to Senator Dianne Feinstein and Senator Lindsey Graham, two proud partisans who strive for civility in America's most difficult political battlefields.
The prize seeks to honor elected officials who show authentic, courageous civility in an important moment, or who demonstrate steadfast respect for opposing points of view throughout their careers.
And if every member of Congress, every elected official in our nation, were to emulate the best instincts of Dianne Feinstein and Lindsey Graham, remarkable things would happen. There would be greater respect for those who enter public life, and more people would be inclined to participate in politics, something we have cared deeply about at Allegheny College for nearly 200 years. And that is why today we are honored to present the Allegheny Prize for Civility in Public Life to Senator Dianne Feinstein and Senator Lindsey Graham.
It makes news in politics when you're civil. It's just assumed everywhere else. If you're not civil, you'll get kicked out of your Sunday school class.
I mean, I can sit down with Lindsey, and I believe I could work out a solution to the most complicated problem because he will listen.
And I really respect Dianne Feinstein. She comes from a state totally different than South Carolina, but we define ourselves not by our differences, but what we have in common.
Do Americans want a United States Senate and a House of Representatives that really can do their business, or do they want one that is so polarized and so twisted with partisanship, their ratings are in single digits all throughout America? So we have a big job on our hands to be able to restore civility.
So I'm going to be optimistic. I think we're entering into a time of problem solving, simply because we're running out of the ability not to solve these problems or catching up with us as a nation. So it's an opportunity for those of us who want a problem solved to shine, and this award means a lot to us.
So I thank you for this honor. I don't deserve it, but I'm glad to have it.
You know, Dianne, I don't deserve it either, but I don't deserve most of the crap I get, so I'll take the award.
So thank you very much.
Former Pennsylvania governor and the nation's first Secretary of Homeland Security, Tom Ridge, credited Allegheny College for shining a light on civility at a time when Washington needs it most.
And what we're hoping to celebrate is that you've been successful politically. You've accepted the responsibility of governing, which means you had to reach across the aisle to compromise, to find common ground. And the only way you can begin to have that discussion is to respect the other person's point of view.
President Mullen invited a group of active and engaged Allegheny political science students, members of the college's Center for Political Participation, to attend the press club ceremony.
People just say, oh, civility is dead in politics. But you know what? Allegheny's bringing it back, and this is a model. This is great.
I'm very proud to go to Allegheny. It's a surprise every day to see, wow, we know this person. We know E.J. Dionne gave our graduation speech last year, and then I saw him on Meet the Press 2 days later, and it's You know, it's just very cool.
I really do think, particularly on campus, we can even be very polarized there, so it's really important for us to be able to work together and just to get things done. It's just such a problem today. So I was really proud that our college was doing something that really honored the people that are making that happen.
Don't give up on the political arena. We clearly need the enrichment of young people, young, thoughtful, civil people.
I don't know many schools almost 200 years old, so I'm going to do my best to earn this award. I'll remember it every time I get up and say something. I don't want to disappoint my friends at Allegheny.
The very next day, Senators Graham and Feinstein found themselves in a contentious Judiciary Committee hearing on proposed gun control legislation.
I want to stop 76,000 people from buying guns illegally. That's what a background check does. If you think we're going to do paperwork prosecutions, you're wrong.
How many?
All right.
How many cases?
Senator, if you would withhold just for a moment.
Yeah.
Please.
That's fine.
No expressions one way or another, and let's keep this civil. Senator
right.
Graham and I just got recognized for civility, so I know he'll keep it civil.
As we approach our 200th birthday, Allegheny's exactly where I want it to be, right at the center of the debate on important issues in American life.